Aloha my friends, I'm right here in Ibiza, the island where I grew up. But now let's get back to business and let's talk about football, because that's what you like, right? I don't think you wanna see me swimming like a mermaid, or do you? Okay, let's talk about the Euro Cup. We have the name of the 8 teams that made it to the quarterfinals, that made it to the next round. So let's talk one by one. The first one is Poland. They beat Switzerland in the penalty round. Honestly, I think Switzerland deserved it a little bit more. They fought well. They woke up when Poland scored the first goal. Beautiful goal by Shaqiri. But at the end, in the penalty round, Poland was a little bit more focused. So they are in the quarterfinals. And they're gonna face the winner from Croatia and Portugal. And the winner was Portugal. Lucky charm, they have a lucky charm. I mean, Croatia played a little bit better. In my opinion, a lot of people say that Croatia didn't play good, but it's hard to play when the strategy from the opponent is to kick when Rakitic has the ball and to put a bodyguard right on Modric so he couldn't move the ball. It was a kind of boring game. Croatia tried from time to time, but nobody was risking a lot. And when Croatia did risk it, Portugal used that moment to do the counter-attack and score the only goal, the goal that put them on the quarter-final. So on Thursday, Poland and Portugal, the first game. Then, Wales, Northern Ireland. I expected a little bit more. It was a boring game. Nothing happened until Ireland scored an own goal. And that's how Wales made it to the next round. I'm happy for Wales because it's their first Euro Cup, so I'm happy that they are in the quarterfinals. Belgium played against Hungary. They did a great game. Finally, we saw the Red Devils. They woke up. They found what was missing, and that was Eden Hazard. He was in a great moment, great game from that player. Beautiful goal, beautiful assist. He did everything, and I think they will make it far after that game because it looks like they woke up. 4-0. They beat Hungary, and now they're gonna face on Friday Wales. On the other side, Germany, Slovakia. We saw the Germany that we wanted to see. They found the thing that they were missing, and it was a number 9. It was Mario Gomez. Now they're scoring more goals. We know that they control the game. They get back the ball as soon as they lose it. Cross is beautiful in the midfield. Neuer is a great goalkeeper. They won 3-0 Slovakia, and that's why they made it in the quarterfinals. Then the next game, the best game from the week, Italy against Spain. Spain was too confident. They were expecting Italy to play in the defense and let them play, have the possession of the ball. That's what normally Italy does. But no, Conte changed everything. He changed the strategy, and Italy went right for the goal, attacking a lot until they scored the first goal from Chiellini. And after that, they were a little bit defending a little bit more, controlling the game, and at the end, they cut the chicken from the neck. They scored a second goal, and it was over for Spain. I think Spain is a great national team, but they need a lot of changes. It's not normal that you play with the same 11 players the 4 games. It didn't work out against Croatia. Why don't you change something against Italy? And you put Morata, knowing that Morata plays in Juventus, and the 3 defenders from Italy, they're playing Juventus. They know win too much, and Morata couldn't do anything. But Italy deserved it. Great, great game from the players from Conte, and that's why they're gonna face Germany on Saturday. Also beautiful game, don't miss that one. Then France beat Ireland. I'm still sad about France. They wake up always too late. They don't win like confidently. Luckily, Griezmann woke up and scored 2 goals in 5 minutes to turn the score around. 2-1 they won. I'm happy for Griezmann. Cholo did a great work with him, and he's a beautiful player. I don't mean it sexually. So 2-1 for France, and they are going to be in the quarterfinals, and they are going to face Iceland, an Iceland that put a surprise. Yes, England wanted to be out of the European Union. I didn't know they wanted to be out of the Euro Cup too. Great game from Iceland. They haven't lost any game at the moment in the Euro Cup. I like the Vikings. They are strong physically, and they can surprise a lot. That's why they are now in the quarterfinals. Very happy for them. And now I will tell you my prediction from the teams that will go and make it to the next round, but that's just my opinion, and I also will tell you why. But I also would like to know which one are your favorites to make it to the semi-final. Poland, Portugal. I haven't seen a lot from these two teams. Someone must to wake up in this game. I don't have anything about Portugal, Cristiano Ronaldo, Pepe. Maybe I'm sad because they knocked out Croatia, but I think Poland will make it. But hopefully we see a good game, because those two teams have been, and they have played very sadly in this tournament. I will go with Poland. Then Wales, Belgium. If we see the same Belgium against Hungary, I think they will make it. Sadly for Wales, they're been doing great. I think Belgium will be in the semi-final against Poland. Then on the other side, Italy, Germany. I will leave it for the end. France, Iceland. France, like I said before, is waking up too late, and Iceland can surprise them. So this time I will support the Vikings. I think the host will stay home for the semi-finals. They will not make it to the next round. So this time I think Iceland will win France. Hopefully, we'll see what happens. And then Germany, Italy. It's so hard because my mother is German, my father is Italian. I don't know who I should support. But I think, honestly, that Italy will make it to the next round. I know Germany is a great team. They are the world champions. They control the ball a lot. They know how to play, and they are the favorites. But Conte has shown that he has a trick or a strategy for every single team that he's going to face. And I think he has something, a magic trick under the sleeve to show us when they're going to play against Germany. And I think Italy will make it to the semi-final against Iceland. That's my prediction. What's yours, guys? What's yours? I want to know. Well, guys, if you are not subscribed to our No Nation channel, what are you waiting for? Just click the spotlight right here below and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat to know everything about Football Club Barcelona. And I just say bye-bye from Ibiza. We'll be right back.